The Italian Job is a 1969 comedy crime caper starring Michael Caine. Caine, who younger viewers may recognise as Alfred from Christopher Nolan's Dark Knight trilogy, plays Charlie Croker, a London Cockney professional thief. The film's main antagonist, a mafia crime boss, is portrayed by Godfather 3's Ralph Vallone. Stage and screen actor Noël plays London crime lord Mr. Bridger, and UK comedy legend Benny Hill stars as the exceedingly clumsy Professor Peach. Filmed on an estimated budget of $3 million, the movie received moderate praise on release, but over the years has grown to prominence as the result of multiple UK bank holiday airings. Produced by Michael Dealy, a man responsible for such colossal hits as The Deer Hunter, Blade Runner, and The Man Who Fell to Earth, the film's plot revolves around a smash and grab of a gold transit convoy en route from Turin Airport to the Fiat car factory in Italy.
You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off!
Charlie Croker has just been released from Her Majesty's Prison London. He is picked up in a suave car by his girlfriend Lorna, played by Margaret Blye. On investigation of the glove box, Charlie discovers that he is a passenger in the recently stolen car belonging to the Pakistani ambassador. Things are already off to a great start for the recently exonerated crook. Returning to his hotel room, Croker is met by the barrel of a gun, held by a mysterious gunman. It is revealed that the would-be assassin is the widow of Charlie's recently deceased crime associate, Roger Beckerman. She hands him a duffel bag consisting of two film canisters. The canisters contain a short movie of Beckerman describing his ingenious plot. The plot consists of a $4 million gold heist on a convoy on its way to the Fiat car manufacturing plant in Turin, Italy. On viewing this, Charlie has the bright idea to break back into jail and offer the job to Mr. Bridger, a crime kingpin who runs his gangline empire from the comfort of his luxury prison cell. On first hearing this proposal, Bridger is quick to diminish the ludicrous scheme. The crime boss suddenly has a change of heart when it is brought to his attention by a Financial Times article that the Chinese are delivering a large shipment of gold bullion to the Fiat automakers as a down payment on construction of a car plant in Peking, China. This information inspires Bridger to supply Croker with the motors and the muscle to get the job done. The film is fantastically scored by Quincy Jones, the man responsible for launching Michael Jackson's solo pop career, and beautifully captured by cinematographer Douglas Slocum, whose work includes Never Say Never Again, Rollerball, and the original Indiana Jones trilogy. Although it is Michael Caine's name that adorns the top of the bill, it is in fact the Mini Cooper that is the shining star of this picture. Italian car firm Fiat offered to pay the film producers a great sum of £50,000 and supply all cars featured in the film, as the production swapped out the Mini Coopers for the similarly built Fiat 500. But the producers felt removing the minis from the picture would cause the movie to lose a vast amount of its British charm. From the fashion to the music, and most importantly the cars, The Italian Job perfectly captures the essence of the 1960s. With ferocious pacing, picture-perfect cinematography, and death-defying stunt scenes, it really is the quintessential Sunday afternoon movie, and I can highly recommend picking it up on Blu-ray.